Yeah, good morning students. Now in this class we are going to talk about queues. Okay, so generally queue is a non-linear linear data structure. If you see the classifications of data structures, generally data structures are classified into two types, that is primitive and non-primitive. Under non-primitive category we have linear and non-linear. In the linear again we have four types, that is arrays, linked list, stack and queue. Okay, at the same time non-linear data structure we have trees, graphs. So in last class we have studied about a stack data structure, which is a linear data structure. In the stack, what is a stack? We can call a stack is a lost and first out, LIFO. Okay, what is a stack, how we are going to represent the stack, and what are the various basic operations of stack. Okay, at the same time what are the algorithms for operations, along with how we are going to represent the stack, and finally various applications of stack we have seen in the stack concept. Now in this concept we are going to concentrate on next linear data structure called as queue. Okay, we can call queue is a first in first out. Okay, first in, FIFO. Okay, so here generally if you take the real time examples of queue, see here generally if you take one counter, okay, just a reservation counter, generally one person giving a tickets inside your room. See, the persons who are willing to take the tickets are coming into the queue. Okay, that means insertion is at one end. See here, after taking the tickets, okay, that person removing at the front end. Okay, that means after taking the person, he will again never go back. Okay, after collecting the tickets at the reservation counter, the person will go out at the front end. Okay, see again, second person also will came to the reservation counter. See, that person will take the, after taking the tickets, that person will remove, that means will out, will remove from the queue at the front end. Here the thing is, insertion is one end and deletion, the person is deleted at that means removing at one end. Okay, here the one representation is here. If you see the diagrammatical representation, there is a person sitting in front of a reservation counter. Here the person is at front. Okay, after collecting the tickets, this person will remove from the queue at the front end only. Okay, here the thing is, we have in queue we have two ends, that is front end and rear end. Okay, so insertion is done at rear end, that is lost end, and deletion is done at front end, that is starting end. Okay, see here the thing is, whereas in stack insertion and deletion can be takes place at only one end, here the thing is in queues insertion and deletions can be takes place at two ends. Okay, so ticket reservation counter is one of the real time example for queue. And next one is, here if you see the representation again, here we have there are five persons are there now. See, five persons are came into the queue. Here one person is at front. After collecting the tickets, the person will remove from the queue at the front end only. Okay, here the thing is, insertion is a rear end, deletion is at front end. Okay, see, at the same time here there is one more example. Like now, if you take the traffic signals, okay, see the vehicles waiting in front of a traffic signals. Okay, see, it will follow the first in first out. It means the vehicle which came first or near to the signal, that vehicle only will move out and the signal is green. Okay, so it is one of the real time example for queue. Okay, here the thing is, insertion is one end and deletion is another end. Okay, so as a one more computer related real time examples are, see the persons waiting in front of a queue. Okay, just now we have said na, okay, suppose there are a number of customers in front of a counter to get the service, whatever it may be. Okay, to collect tickets or some withdraw or deposit money in a teller of a bank. Okay, here the customer are forming a queue and they will be served in the order they arrive. Okay, okay? That is, a customer who come first will be served first, okay? So it is one of the example, a real time example. Next one is a traffic signals. Just now I have said now. See here, suppose there is a turning point in a highway where the traffic has to turn. All the traffic will have wait in a line till it get a signal for moving. Okay, on getting the signal go, the vehicle will run, will turn, or will run on the first come first turn basis. Okay, so this is also one of the example for queue. So next one is if you observe these examples, the thing is, we should know one thing, that is, in queues, the insertion and deletion operations can be done at two ends, okay? That is, the insertion is one end and the deletion is another end, okay? We can say insertion can be done at rear end and the deletion can be done at front end, okay? See, here, based on this one, if we see the queue, like stacks, queue, it is a data structure that holds a sequence of elements. That means a queue may contain sequence of homogeneous elements, same elements, okay? Generally, in ordinary English, queue is defined as a waiting a line, like a line of people waiting to purchase some tickets. Here, the first person in the line is the first person to collect tickets, okay? And one more thing is, a queue is another special kind of list where items are inserted at one end called rear end and deleted at other end called front end. See, another name for queue is first in first out, FIFO. A queue is a FIFO data structure in which elements are accessed from two different ends called front and rear. The thing is only one, that is, in queues the insertion and deletion operations can be done at two ends, that is rear end and front end respectively. In the queues, the elements are inserted into a queue through the rear end and are removed from the front end. And one more thing is, here in the stack we are going to maintain one variable called top. Here in this queue also, queue maintain two variables called front and rear. Front refers to the first position of the queue, whereas rear refers to the last position of the queue. At the same time, in the queue, the elements are removed in the order of that in which they were added to the queue. That is, first element inserted is to be deleted first. Okay, that's why you can call it as a first in, first out. Okay. See, here queue is the technical definition of a queue. Queue is a ordered collection of homogeneous elements in which insertion and deletion operations can be done at two ends, okay? And one more thing is, a queue is a linear data structure like an array, a stack and a linked list where the ordered of elements in a linear fashion. The only difference between stack and queue is that in the case of stack, the insertion and deletion, okay, we can call insertion is push, deletion is pop. That means in the stack, in the case of stack, the push and pop operations can be done at only one end, that is top end, whereas in queue, okay, the insertion and deletion operations can be done at two ends, that is rear end and front end respectively, okay. In stack, insertion operation we can call it as a push, deletion operation we can call it as a pop. In this queue, like that only, in queues, insertion operation we can call it as a end queue, whereas deletion operation we can call it as a DQ, okay? NQ and DQ. See, this is the definition of a queue, okay? Then what are the basic operations of queue? Here, the operations for a queue are analogous to those for a stack. The difference is that the insertion go at the end of the list rather than the beginning. See, some of the operations, basic operations of the queue are, first one is NQ. NQ is nothing but insertion. So it is like, no, insertion is nothing but, here we can call it as NQ. NQ is a term which is used to insert the element at rear end. Okay. And one more thing is DQ. Okay. DQ which deletes an element at the starting of the queue. Okay. We can say insertion and deletion. Okay. Insertion means to add an item to the rear end of the queue. The rear end always points to the recently added item. Okay, here the same thing only, okay, insertion is nothing but NQ. NQ is nothing but insertion. Okay, at the same time deletion. Deletion is nothing but DQ. This is nothing but to delete the item from the front end of the queue. The front end always points to the recently removed element. And at the same time, next one is a display, or we can say traverse, visiting each and every data element present in queue. Okay, so the next one is empty. Empty is nothing but it determines the queue is empty or not. Okay, so next one is empty. Empty or is empty, both are similar only. Is empty is nothing but to check whether the queue is empty or not. Okay, is full. It is nothing but to check whether the queue is full or not. It reports the user whether the queue is full or not. Is full means if the queue is full or not. Okay, so all these are the basic operations of queue. Okay, major thing is NQ, DQ, display, or traverse, empty, full, or we can say is empty, is full. Okay, then what are the various representations of queue? How we are going to represent the queue? Okay, generally we are going to represent the queue in two ways. That is, first one is array representation, and the second one is linked list representation. Array representation, and the second one is linked list representation. Okay, see here, by seeing this, we should know the conditions for queue is full and queue is empty. See, what is the condition for queue is empty and what is the condition for queue is full? Okay, see, these two conditions we are going to learn here by seeing this representations. Okay, see, the first kind of representation uses one dimensional array, and it is better choice where a queue of fixed size is required. The other representation is a double linked list, and it will provide a queue whose size can be vary during the processing. And here this representation is queue using array. Here we have a number of elements, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, n minus 2, n minus 1, and then finally n. Here the insertion can be done at rear end. Okay, at the same time deletion can be done at front end. Okay, see, for example, if this queue, the size of the queue is 1 to n. See, for example, assume that if the queue is full means, see, what is the front value? Front equal to 1 and rear equal to n. It means the queue is full. That means it will, the size of the queue is 1 to n only. Okay, in this queue we have the elements from 1 to n. Okay, see, at the time what is the front value? Front equal to 1 and rear equal to n. It means queue is full. Okay, see, the condition for queue is full is front equal to 1 or rear equal to n. Or we can say, if I starts with instead of 1, from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, like that, and so on, and then what is the, in that case, what is the condition for queue is full? Front equal to 0, rear equal to n. Okay, of course, here the thing is, insertion is rear end, front end is deletion. Okay, here a one dimensional array queue of 1 to n can be used to represent a queue. Here, instance of us, it will show the, in this diagram shows the instance of a such type of queue. With this representation, two pointers, namely front and rear, we are going to use to indicate two ends of the queue. For the insertion of the next element, the pointer rear will be consultant, and for deletion, the pointer front will be the consultant. Okay. Here, by seeing this representation, you should know what is the condition for queue is full, f equal to 1, rear equal to n. Then what is the condition for queue is empty? Here at present queue is empty only, na? Whenever queue is empty, see, always front and rear will be at one place only. Okay, queue empty means front and rear will be at one place. That is, whenever front equal to 1, rear equal to 1, then we can say queue is empty. Or simply by f equal to 1, front equal to 1, rear equal to 1, then automatically we can say front equal to rear. If whenever front equal to rear, or we can say front equal to 1, rear equal to 1, then we can say queue is empty. Okay. Here, the conditions for queue is empty or queue is full. Okay. The queue is empty means front equal to 0 or rear equal to 0. Or we can say front equal to 1, rear equal to 1. Why? Because If the q starts from 1 onwards, we can say front equal to 1, rear equal to 1. Or if the q starts from 0 onwards, okay, we can say front equal to 0, rear equal to 0. Okay, automatically, if front equal to 0, rear equal to 0 means front equal to rear. Or second one is front equal to 1, rear equal to 1 means second front equal to rear only. By seeing this, simply we can say whenever front equal to rear, we can say q is empty. And next one is, what is the condition for q full? Q full is nothing but whenever front equal to 1, rear equal to n, then we can say q is full. Okay. See, these two conditions are very important whenever we are working with the algorithms. Okay. Then the second representation is q using linked list. Okay. Here, linked list means we are going to take double linked list. Okay. See, double linked list means it is also a collection of nodes which are connected by a two links. Okay. In double linked list, each node consists of three nodes. Okay. That is left address, data, and right address. Okay. In a node may have three parts: left address, data, and right address. In the left address, we are going to store the address of the previous node. In data part, we are going to store the actual data. In the right address, we are going to store the address of the next node. Okay. All the nodes are connected by two links. Okay. Of course, the first node address will be stored onto the header. The first node left address part will contain the null. At the same time, the last node right address, okay, part will contain the null also. Okay. Here, one more limitation of a queue other than the inadequate service of insertion represented with an array is the rigidness of its length. In several applications, the length of the queue cannot be predicted before it varies accurately. To overcome this problem, another preferable representation of a queue is a linked list. Here we can select a double linked list which allows us to move both ways. Here the pointers front and rear point the first node and the last node in the list. Okay. See, if we take one queue, okay, list of elements, those list of elements we are going to take, we are going to represent those list of elements in the double linked list manner. Okay. And next one is, whenever we are working with queue, each and every time, if I am going to perform the insertion operation, what will happen? And at the same time, if I am going to perform the deletion, here insertion means NQ, deletion means DU, what will happen? See, in stack, we have seen like, no, whenever we are performing the push operation, then top will become top plus 1, whereas whenever I am going to perform the pop operation, top will become top minus 1. Like that only. Here, let us take one Q. Initially, Q is empty. Okay, see here 0 to 4, total number of size of the queue is 5, that is 0 to 4. Here f and rear will be at 0. It means stack queue is empty. Just now I have said, now what is the condition for queue empty? Front equal to 0 or rear equal to 0, or we can say front equal to rear. It means front rear should be at one position only. Okay, it is at 0. Okay, it is the first one. Again, second, what will happen? First of all, I am going to insert the one element, that is 11, to the queue. Generally, insertion can be done at which end? Insertion can be done at rear end. That means the rear position only move. That means the rear will become from 0 to 1. Okay, rear will become 0 to 1. It means 0 to 1 means rear equal to rear plus 1, that is 0 plus 1. Okay. Front will not change. Why? Because front end only for deletion, rear end is for insertion only. Okay. Again, I am going to insert the one more element, 22. Again, I am going to insert the one more element, 22. Then which end will move? Rear end. Why? Because insertion can be done at rear end only. Okay. So now the rear will become from 1 to 2. Now what will happen? The condition is rear equal to rear plus 1. That equal to 2. Okay. Again, front equal to 0 only. Again, I am going to insert one more element, 33. Okay, automatically which end will move? Rear end only will move from 2 to 3. Okay, again, in this case also rear equal to rear plus 1. Okay, here the thing is, whenever I am going to performing the insertion operation or NQ, insertion operation. Always insertion operation can be done at rear end only. So whenever I am going to performing the insertion operation, rear end will become rear plus one. The front end won't change. Okay, so you should remember this one for insertion. Again, here comfort deletion. Okay, now I am going to delete an element. Okay, delete an element 11. Okay, so automatically deletion can be done at which end? Front end. Okay, so front end will move from 0 to 1. So here again front what happened? Front equal to front plus 1, that is 0 plus 1, 1. So rear will not move, rear is a 3 only. Okay, again after 11 I am going to delete 22. Okay, if you performing the deletion operation in DQ operation, then it should be at front end only. So next element is 22. So if I perform the deletion of 22, then automatically front will become from 1 to 2. Front changes from 1 to 2. Then what will happen? Front equal to front plus 1. Okay. Again, now rear equal to 3, front equal to front plus 1. That means front equal to 2. Okay. Here, the thing is, you should observe, whenever I am going to perform the deletion operation, the front equal to front plus 1. The condition is front equal to front plus 1. Okay. Whereas insertion operation, rear equal to rear plus 1. Deletion operation, front equal to front plus 1. Okay. Now, front is at 2, rear is at 3. Now, I am going to insert two more elements, that is 44 and 55. Then automatically rear will become 5. Why? Because two elements I have inserted now. 3 plus 4, 3 plus 2. Generally, if I insert 1, front equal to front plus 1, 2 means front equal to front plus 2. Okay. Then automatically rear will become 5. Okay. There is no change in front. No change in front. Okay. If you observe here, what will happen is the front end is at 2 and the rear end is at 5. That means if you observe here, it will show the queue is full. Okay. Why? Because the rear end will show the fifth location, that is fifth position. Okay. See, if I want to insert the element at rear end, okay, here it will show the queue is full. Okay, even though we have two vacant positions 0 and 1, the rear end will show at fifth location. We cannot insert the element even though we have two vacant positions. Why? Because here the rear end will show the queue full status. Okay, I'm saying the insertion operation. Okay, so this is one of the drawback in queues. Okay, this drawback can be avoided by using the circular queue concept. Okay, of course the solution was we should shift the three elements. If I want to insert, okay, I'm going to shift the three elements towards left. Okay, automatically there is vacant position, that means automatically the rear end will move, then I'm going to insert the element. Okay, here the thing is shifting of elements will take more time. Okay, so in order to avoid that drawback, we are going to use the concept called as circular queue. Okay, so here that thing only I have explained here. Next, I am going to insert another element, 66. Okay, see here we can't insert 66 to the queue as the rear end cross the maximum size of the queue. Okay, why? Because it is 5. There will be queue full signal. The queue status will be like this only. Okay. And now it is not possible to insert an element 66 even though there are two vacant positions in the linear queue. Okay. To overcome this problem, the elements of the queue are be shifted towards the beginning of the queue so that it will create vacant position to the rear end. Then the front and rear are to be adjusted properly. The element 66 can be inserted at the rear end. After performing the insertion of 66, then we are going to get the final representation. That is, after 66, after inserting the 66, okay, the rear end will move from 3 to 4. Okay, that is again now rear will become 4, front equal to 0. Okay, of course this is one of the difficulty. this difficulty can overcome if we treat a cube position with index 0 as a position that come after position with index 4, that is, we treat a cube as a circular cube. Here the thing is, this problem we are going to avoid by using the circular cube. Okay, in circular cube what will happen, we are going to arrange the elements in a circular manner. Okay, after 4, again if it is a circular cube, after 4, if we represent the elements in a circular manner, after 4th position again we are going to get the 0th position. Okay, so in that case we are going to insert. Okay, so of course this problem we are going to solve in the priority queue concept. Okay, so here this is the difficulty in queues. Okay, so this is regarding queues and the representation of queues. Okay, so now in this class we have studied about the what is a queue, what is the representation of the queue. Okay, what is the condition for queue full and queue empty. So what is the condition for queue full? Whenever f equal to 1, rare equal to n, then we can say queue is full. And what is the condition for queue empty? Simply front equal to rare, or front equal to 0, rare equal to 0, or front equal to 1, rare equal to 1. Then we can say front equal to queue is empty. Okay. Then what are the basic operations of queue? Okay. And at the same, how we are going to represent the queue? Okay, then what happened if I am going to insert one element? Okay, what happened whenever I am going to insert one element, the front will become, sorry, rare will become, insert can be rare and only, in a rare equal to rare plus 1. Whenever I am going to perform the deletion operation, then front will become 1 plus 1. Okay, so all these are the topics we have covered in this class. Okay, thank you.